Luigi's Mansion 3 came out at the end of October, Halloween. Of course it did. It was spoopy. It's crazy to me that Luigi's Mansion 3 even exists in the first place. It was the first outing of Luigi's personality.
Hello?
The defined Luigi's sort of scaredy cat, but still brave personality. So I'm so glad to see that Nintendo is fully embracing Luigi's Mansion. The fact that we got Luigi's Mansion 2 on the 3DS, that's gotta be it. That's the end of the line for Luigi's Mansion. But I am proud to say that I was absolutely wrong about that. Let's just see how this game holds up against the original game and vice versa. So when you first start up Luigi's Mansion 3, it doesn't look like this at all. In fact, it looks more like this. The hills are alive with the sound of absolutely no ghosts.
I went to driver's school. Oh my god! Oh my god, get out of my way! Everything is gonna be okay!
So this game is actually just the plot of RV.
Ow! Oh god! Ow! Ah.
So we start off here at the hotel. Everything is happy-go-lucky. And Luigi and the crew are excited to go on vacation. Unfortunately, whenever somebody here in the Mushroom Kingdom goes on vacation, everything has to fall apart. Everybody remember Mario Sunshine? Remember what happened there? Mario became a convicted felon, okay?
This appears to be quite a predicament.
This cannot be good. Oh man, they were even expecting us. I guess we are royalty? I forget that Peach is actually the leader of a country. Oh, Boulder Pop. Oh, he's such a good boy. Peach, I forgot that you were royalty for a second. I'm sorry. your majesty, I guess.
This hotel is so big, Luigi. It's so big.
Now, let it be known that I have not completed Luigi's Mansion 3 as of making this video. So this isn't a review or anything. It's just I want to compare the beginnings of the two games. So with that being said, let's jump over to Luigi's Mansion 1 and check out what the beginning of that game looks like today. So, the plot of this game goes, Luigi wins a contest, a random contest in the paper that says he won a mansion, and he shows up to this mansion and doesn't immediately run away for some reason.
Hello?
All right, here we go. Wow, we are in it right away. Mm-hmm. No big fanfare in the foyer, the foyer. There's no fanfare. We don't know where Peach is. We don't know where Mario is. As far as we know, nobody is around. Here, let's go, hang on. I wanna see what happens if I try to go through this door. Ah, okay, never mind. That just literally just does damage. Okay, I'm humping things. That's right, he humps things. The animations are kind of unfortunate in this game, huh?
Oh, no.
Luigi's Mansion 1 was one of my all-time favorite GameCube games. It was a launch title for the GameCube, so I sort of give it a little bit of leeway on its jankiness. There is some jank to it, but it was such a cool, unique idea in such a small, fun little package, little adventure. You know, it didn't drag on for too long. It was just the right length with just the right amount of puzzles and characters, and I loved it. It was amazing. It had unique gameplay, interesting characters, and enemies. You should be terrified of Luigi. He'll suck you. Egad, it's my boy! Oh, not today, old man. Not today. Maybe another day. And also, what are you doing in my new house? In the original, it was as simple as flashing the ghosts and sucking them up. And that's literally it. In Luigi's Mansion 3, you get this slam technique, which is a way better way of capturing the ghosts, and something you're gonna be doing the entire game, basically. But in this one, you're just sucking dudes. I mean, ghosts, sucking ghosts. Don't mince my words. Ah, four at once! Four dudes at once! I'm sucking four dudes at once!
Boo ho ho! Where did you go, Mario? Mario! Huh? Luigi? Can you help us? No, you can't, because you're a pussy!
You know, there really is no reason not to subscribe to the channel. If you scroll down, tap that subscribe button and the bell, I will love you forever.
What the f- Oh my god, why are you like this? You're such a klutz! Look at what this asshole did again!
Ding ding, it is me, Luigi, your esteemed guest.
Welcome, guests, to the last resort.
Guests, welcome to the last resort. My name is Helen Gravely, and I'm gravely important here. I'm gravely delighted that you accepted my invitation. I just can't wait to put you in my grave. You must all be very tired. Come. Sleep. Oh, no need to worry about your luggage. Our exceptional staff will take care of it for you. See? Let's-a-go, he said. Let's-a-go, that's right, Mario. You say the thing that you say. You say that one thing you say.
Oh.
Mario, Luigi, and Peach's rooms are over here. We've prepared graves for the toads as well. I hope you enjoy your stay. I dare say you'll remember it for the rest of your lives. Which is really, really short now. Bye forever.
Bye.
Okay. Bye.
Bye. Ha, bye forever. Hi.
I don't know why Peach sounded a little bit like Mickey Mouse just now, but... All right, Luigi. I think it might be time to kick your feet up and have a relaxing vacation. What do you think? What do you think, Polterpup? Aw, look. They even have a bathrobe out for us.
Oh, isn't that just a good boy? Aren't you just a good boy?
Okay, wow. Okay, the toilet... The toilet is a little forceful, you know? It's got a built-in bidet. Maybe we'll order some room service, Luigi. Ah! Right back at you, buddy. No, all right. Enough of this. No more surprises. I'm done with surprises for today. Yes, it's time to relax. Look, we are on vacation. It's time for us to enjoy ourselves, kick our feet up, relax. Wait a minute. Who goes to bed fully clothed with their shoes on? Luigi, what are you doing? That's a mood. Luigi's Mansion 1 was one of my all-time favorite GameCube games. As I mentioned earlier in the video, it is a launch title for the GameCube, so I kind of give it a pass for any of the jankiness that might have been involved in it being a brand new GameCube game on a brand new generation of consoles. One key difference that I'd like to highlight between the original and Luigi's Mansion 3 is actually the progression, because they kind of go back to the way that you progress through each room in Luigi's Mansion 3. Like, they kind of go back to this idea of entering each room with a key and then clearing it out and going from... The way that it progresses in Luigi's Mansion 1 is chapter-based. So you complete a chapter, and it has a set number of ghosts and challenges and objectives, and then you return to Gadd's lab at the end of the chapter to, like, check up on everything and put your portrait ghosts away. And then you check back into the mansion and make your way onto the next floor or whatever you're doing. Luigi's Mansion 2 does progression in a totally different way, where it's all mission-based. So it's kind of the same idea, but broken up into even more chunks per chapter. And then they went the totally opposite direction of all of that for Luigi's Mansion 3 and had the progression be very natural. You complete the ghosts, you beat them in boss fights and capture them, and steal back the buttons that you need for the elevator of the hotel. The elevator. Ah, Peach, what happened? Where are we? Oh, that's right, we're on vacation.
Hello?
Yes, this place looks exactly as I left it when I went to bed. Nothing's changed here. Oh no, certainly not. Ah! Thumbs up? Thumbs up! Jesus Christ! There's a gargoyle outside my window! Ah! Surely the bathroom is safe. Surely the bathroom is safe! There's bones! Mario, are you okay? Mario? Mario? Mario! Look at how much pizza he ordered and didn't invite us over for any. And look, he even left some just laying around the floor. Like, man, come on, you could have given me this piece of pizza, dude! Ah! Trash or trapped in the painting for all of life. Trash or trapped in the painting for all of life. Trash or... Trash! Posting videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday from here on out. Guys, thank you so much for watching, liking, commenting, and subscribing, and I will see you in the next one.